With Istio, you can also secure the traffic leaving your cluster through an egress gateway. You can even originate traffic, the TLS traffic that's coming from the gateway, but all of this is not so straightforward as you need to know Istio quite well to be able to create the corresponding service entries, the gateways, the destination roles, virtual services, and so on. So we'll show how it's a lot easier to do this with the Gloo platform. You should also be aware that it's easy to bypass this egress gateway if a malicious user wanted to. And to prevent that, you need to configure some CNI level network policies to enforce that the traffic always goes through the egress gateway. So we'll show you how to do both easily. So we're going to show in Gloo platform where you can see Istio running in both clusters. We also have Cilium CNI deployed, which is going to enforce the network policy. So right now we don't have an egress gateway. So just like we did before with the ingress gateways, we will use the Gateway Lifecycle Manager to tell the platform to automate the deployment of this egress gateway. It's going to be pretty quick because we already have the operator running. So as soon as you apply it, a few seconds later, it's already running. I can also create a virtual gateway now to listen to incoming traffic coming from the other pods to send traffic outside. And here you can decide which services you want to be exposed through this egress gateway. In this case, we're just going to use httpbin.org. And now for the network policy, we will create this in the bookinfo frontend's namespace. And what this is doing, it's that for the services that are running in this namespace, so for example, product page in our case, you can now talk to any other pods in the namespace, but cannot talk to anything outside of the cluster. So it can talk to the egress gateway because it's another pod in the cluster, but it can't talk to HTTP bin directly. It can also talk to this IP address because this IP address corresponds with the remote cluster's east-west gateway for east-west traffic between the Kubernetes clusters. So these are all the things that we're allowing with this network policy. So let's create this network policy that's going to be enforced by Cilium. And now let's try it. If I try to access this HTTP bin service, and we're going to access it through the product page pod, and you can see that I get no response. And that's because the packets are dropped by the CNI. So just like we expect, the pod is not able to access HTTP bin because the network policy is restricting access. So what I need to do now is I need to create this external service, this service registry element that represents httpbin.org. And I can define that the request be sent plain text by the user on the product page. And that's going to be originating the TLS communication that's going to go through the gateway that I have defined before. So when we do this, it's going to create a lot of that Istio resources for you automatically, like the ones we talked about earlier, the virtual services for the gateway, the egress gateway. It's going to create a destination rule. So this is a destination rule. It's going to create the service entry. And all of this complexity is being managed by the Gloo platform. So the user just has to create the external service to make it possible for this for your pods to access this endpoint. So now if I run the same command again, it should work because we should go through the egress gateway, and I can check that here by looking at the logs. I can see that I can access the service correctly, and I can check the logs of the egress gateway, and everything is working perfectly. So that's just the start. We can actually do much more. We can now apply layer 7 policies. For example, we can create an access policy to tell who should talk to this HTTP bin service. So for example, in here, we're saying the product page bin service should be able to talk to the external service through the gateway. And we can also define other layer 7 things, like say we only want to allow get requests. And over here, we can have this enforcement layer option where we can decide when we create an access policy, if we want that policy to be translated by the platform to into an Istio authorization policy with mesh equals to true, or network policies with CNI equals to true. So if we have just mesh, then it won't create a network policy, and it'll just create it at the gateway level in the mesh. So now we'll create this rule, and now I should still be able to access HTTP bin like we were doing before, because we were doing a GET request. But if I try to change this a POST request, we should get access denied. As you can see, 403 RBAC access denied. So you can see how we used the platform to simplify the configuration of deploying the egress gateway itself, but also the configuration of all the various egress rules. It's all very simple, and we were able to leverage the CNI in conjunction with the service mesh to make sure we have full control, defense in depth, basically, of egress traffic with full granularity that we saw and expect.